Also the York Sport Council president last season and has also looked out for the best interests of the football team. Ed Michael, who is accompanied today by his parents Albert and Judy, was starting center on the team's offensive line until injuries prevented him from playing at his best. He's a tremendous leader and has served a mentor for the younger offensive linemen with the program. Jesse Murden, who is accompanied today by his parents Carolyn and Andrew, is a hard-working receiver who is dedicated to the gym. He has been a loyal member of the program for the last 5 years and has been a regular starter on offense under the current coaching staff. Pat Russell, who is accompanied today by his mother Patricia, grandpa Patrick, and girlfriend Lisa, is a dynamic defensive lineman who is a dual threat on running and passing plays. He brings high energy to the team, takes a lot of snaps, and is an all-round great football player. He is also a team captain. Specialist for the Lions in his years with the program. Colin Samples, who is accompanied today by his mother and father, Shirley and Greg, is a hard-working receiver who has been eager to learn since joining the program last season. He dedicated himself to improving up this year and earned a place on the dress roster on special teams. Demetar Sevden, who is accompanied today by his mother Emma and girlfriend Alanda, is an intelligent quarterback who has played regularly in 5 years with the program. He is described by his coaches as a team guy and has been a dedicated, loyal member of the Lions. Zachary Thomas, who is accompanied today by his parents Mark and Grace, is a hard-working, team-first defensive player whose play was limited by injuries throughout his time at the Lions. He has been an important piece of the program as a veteran player on the young unit. Jonel Talbert, who is accompanied today by his parents Monique and Emmanuel, has been an offensive threat and a game-changer as a wide receiver in his years with the program. This year has been the team's leading receiver in yards, and he is second in the OUA with 6 touchdown catches. Gentlemen, we thank you for your hard work and dedication to the program, and we'll miss you next season. Good luck with all your future. It's now time to introduce today's teams. First, entering from the south end tunnel of the stadium, please welcome the visiting Guelph Gryphons. Officials for today's game is Glenn Hill, Paul Pawlowski, Richard Tyrell, Chris Venter, Mike Seward, Gress McCray, and Trevor Semple.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we would ask that you would please rise, remove your caps, and join us for the playing of our national anthem. We would like to welcome
afternoon, everyone, and welcome to York Stadium, the home of the York Lions here in Toronto, Ontario. I'm Edan Posner here with Jessica Osterhan, and we're set to tee you up for the York Lions season finale against the Guelph Gryphons. And Jessica, the record might not indicate it for York this season, but a lot better a year than we've seen in the past for them.
Well, absolutely. Two wins on the season. They haven't had more than one since 2005, Edan. So it is a very, very bright season for the York Lions. Two wins and a huge one coming last week as well.
Well, not quite bright enough, as York won't be in the playoffs this season, but arguably the sweetest win in the past couple of years coming last week against their bitter rivals at U of T.
Well, the Red and Blue Bowl is always a huge game for both teams, and for York to come out on top of that is an absolutely huge accomplishment for them.
Well, York will look to have another accomplishment notched in their belt today. They look to close out their season with a W here against Guelph. Kickoff coming up in just a few.
Thank you.
Welcome everyone to York Stadium for the York Lions season finale against the Guelph Gryphons. As you see, Guelph has kicked off the ball, York returning, and knee the ball down in the end zone. So York offense comes out onto the field for their first drive of the day. And the last time these two teams met, the Guelph Gryphons defeated the Lions in a blowout, 51-2, the final score, but a different York Lions team this season.
Absolutely, and I mean, they have a lot of graduating players this year, and as you saw taking the kickoff there was Kyle Exume, and he just stays on the field, so you can already tell that he is going to be a big impact in this game, or so Coach Craney hopes.
And another big impact player is now under center, Miles Gibbon, who takes the snap and gives it to his running back, Exume, playing his final game, and he pushes it up the middle for just a couple of yards.
Just a couple so far, but I'm sure he'll tack on a few more. He had a great game last week. He was actually named the Chili's Athlete of the Week. He had three rushing touchdowns last week for a huge win against the U of T Varsity Blues.
And not a big back, just 5'9", 200 pounds, but always seems to find a way to get it done and always drags defenders downfield with him. So Miles Gibbon out in shotgun now on second down, and throws it out to the sidelines. That's Nathaniel Griffith, number 88, to the sidelines. Looks just short of a first down, maybe about 2 or 3 yards, so third down.
Looks pretty slick out there. Griffith took a little bit of a tumble.
And third down. We'll see what York decides to do here, but early on in the game, maybe looking to make a statement in this, again, the finale of the season for York. The 2-5 York Lions taking on the 6-1 Guelph Gryphons. Here is Gibbon throwing to the side, and he has a first down. Kyle Exume, and no one is covering him. He picks up a big chunk of yards down across the 55-yard line and into Guelph territory.
Wow, that was a huge gain by Kyle Exume. They look like they're about at the 39 right now.
And you said it just a couple of plays ago that he only had 2 yards, but he'll probably pick up a couple more and picks up a good chunk there really early in the game. So York looks to be going to their fifth-year running back quite a bit early in the early going. And here's Gibbon again on first down. Gives it right back to the running back, and he has a little jump cut, flag up in the air, picks up a couple more yards, but we'll see what the refs have called on this one. And it's on York.
So this, yeah, that's coming back a little bit, Edon.
So York now a bit closer to midfield. They're at the 51-yard line of Guelph. And it's going to be 1st and 20, so 1st and long. First down marker at the just about the 30-yard line.
There looks to be a little bit of confusion on the field here. Nobody really seems to know what's going on. We've got the water boys coming out. Looks like somebody took a timeout, but I didn't see a signal for one.
Okay, so looks like the refs have waved off the timeout. So York Lions come set again on offense. And it's Gibbon once again. In his first year with York, he's been very, very good. He's in shotgun right now, and he looks down the field but elects to keep it himself. He runs up the middle, loses a couple of defenders, loses a couple more, and he is down the sidelines, close to a first down. Might have gotten it, and it looks like he does get it. So moving the chains with his legs, Miles Gibbon, and we have seen that a ton so far this season.
Miles Gibbon is such a mobile quarterback, and he had a huge game on the ground last week as well. He racked up 102 yards on 16 runs last week, and I think that he, as you can see here, he's probably going to keep that pattern up today.
Well, the evolution of the quarterback has changed so much in the last few years. The value of a mobile quarterback is just so much more now, and here's Gibbon again in shotgun, and once again keeps it himself running right up the gut. And is brought down a lot sooner this time, so picks up about half the distance to the first down. It'll bring up 2nd and about 5.
That looked like it was about 4, it's about 6 yards actually. So in total, those two combined runs were 31 yards for Miles Gibbon.
So guys like York players like Kyle Exume is now working it in the receiving game, so he's picking up yards there. Miles Gibbon electing to use his legs, so York weapons kind of like Swiss Army knives here early on, and Miles Gibbon once again keeps it himself, and he is running again, and that's another first down for the quarterback.
A great start here so far for York. They are deep in the red zone now, and it's going to take a huge defensive stop by Guelph here to keep them out of the end zone.
And York looking nearly unstoppable so far early on in this game. Not quite what we've seen from the 6-1 Guelph Gryphons this season, but York now in the red zone, and it's first and goal, about 9 yards to the end zone. And here's Gibbon in shotgun, gives it to his running back. He sidesteps a few defenders and barrels his way into the goalpost.
He just about took down the goalpost. As you say, he's not a huge back, but man, does that guy have power. The Guelph defense had no chance. Exume just brought all of them into the end zone with him.
So something we haven't seen from the York Lions this season that often, an opening drive touchdown capped off by a 9-yard Kyle Exume touchdown. So York up 6-0. The scoreboard reads 1-0 for Guelph, but that's not the case. 11:50 left to go in the first quarter, and York up a score.
That entire drive was 7 plays.
Extra point almost blocked there, but it goes through. So now 7-0 for York.
For 75 yards, capping that off with a touchdown.
So in their final game of the season, York gets off on the right foot early on, capping off a first drive with a score. Jess, how are they looking so far?
So far, they're looking really good, especially the legs in this one. It seems that Miles Gibbon is either going to use his legs or someone else's, and that someone else so far has been Kyle Exume.
Well, yeah, and it's something we haven't seen that much of. Miles Gibbon was vaunted as the savior and the new face of the franchise here, and he's been very, very good. But a lot of the players at York have just been not playing up to the skill that they have shown in the past, and they haven't put together the flashes of brilliance that we've seen at certain points throughout the season. And now, so far early on, it looks like, well, we haven't seen much from the receiving group yet, but a lot working in the running game for York so far. Now the York Lions will kick off, and we will get our first chance to see both the Guelph Gryphons special teams unit and the Guelph Gryphons offense. Kick is returned just inside the 20 and up the sidelines.
A great kick by York there.
And no, looked like he was brought down back down near the 30, but gets up closer to the 40. So once again, out come the Guelph Gryphons offense.
And we'll see what they can do against this York Lions defense. They couldn't stop the offense. They couldn't stop the York Lions offense, rather. We'll see if the York Lions defense can stop the Guelph Gryphon offense. Taking a couple cues from the NFL, I see some pink shoes out there.
And this offense led by quarterback Jazz Lindsey, who takes a snap in shotgun and looks deep, but the play is blown dead offside on York University.
You know, that's really going to kill them in this game. They can't take penalties like that. It's just going to cost them yardage, and in the end, it's going to crush their spirits a little bit, and we've seen that happen before.
Yeah, a lot of the problem for York has been the fact that this is such a young team, and there's just a lot of discipline issues right now, not keeping the penalties to a minimum. And in the past couple of home games, we've seen especially a lot of the avoidable penalties, really, false starts, offsides, not so much of the aggressive penalties, but more of things that should be locked down and will as time sort of gets under the wings of these younger players. So now it'll be 1st and 5 on the 39-yard line for Jazz Lindsey and the Gryphons. Lindsey this season, 118 completions for 1,441 yards and 11 touchdowns versus just 4 interceptions among the OUA leaders in nearly every offensive category. And Lindsey looks the exact same play down the field, overshoots his receiver, but it looks like another
way overshoots that one. Jordan Nugent just about had a hand on that. If he was a little bit further downfield, he could have had an interception there.
Okay. So first and 10 now for Guelph after that penalty by York, another offside, and now Lindsay keeps the ball himself on a play action, rolls out to the left side and airs it out down the field and overthrows another receiver. So three overthrows early on by Lindsay, two were helped out by penalties, but second down and 10 coming up.
Josh Small just about there for an interception. We all know how dangerous he can be.
Well, the York secondary has been really a shining star for this team all year long. They've been coming up big in games that York is winning and losing, and they just, it's a very young secondary, and as time goes, they're just going to get better and better. It's a very athletic secondary, and they have a nose for the ball.
Jordan Nugent and Josh Small are in the back there playing DB for York, and they seem pretty hungry for an interception.
And Lindsay rolls out one more time, and the exact same play again. This time it's hauled down. Refs call that a completion, and a great job there by number 6 on Guelph.
Adre Frazier,
and a great, great athlete. As we were talking about athletic players, and Frazier there just readjusted in the air to make that catch. And so far we've seen 4 plays from Guelph, and the two at the top were identical, and the two at the bottom identical. And York got burned on that one there on a similar play to the one right before. Now, Jazz Lindsay getting close to the York red zone.
That was a 29-yard gain.
Another quarterback bootleg, and this time throws it down towards the turf, but Carl Trivieri picks that one up, and it's a completion. Nope, they call that an incompletion, so second and 10 coming up. Just about 10 yards out of the red zone, so around the 31-yard line.
Well, that last play was a 29-yard gain for the Guelph Gryphons. They're moving downfield pretty well, Edan. Hopefully, the York defense can stave them off here.
Well, they're a very mobile offense. They like to move guys around, and they like to move their quarterback around, too. And Jazz Lindsay is moving to the left, the right. He's throwing the ball down the field, and he's confusing the York defense right now. And again, he keeps it himself. This one does not confuse the York defense, and he is wrapped up, not taken down, but
Braden Cameron almost had a sack for a huge loss for Guelph there.
And a late flag comes in the backfield. Just waiting to see what the refs call here.
It looks like Guelph might be moving back. And they seem to know it.
Yeah, it looked like they started moving back towards their sidelines a little bit as well as soon as the play happened. So they're calling no play.
Field goal attempt here by the Guelph Gryphons. That's what they're going to go for. And this will be about a 38-yard attempt, would you say? Or no, rather, it's
well,
a 30,
it's a
32.
Longer. Oh, no. Yeah.
About a 32-yard attempt. Oh, for him back there.
Well, he's going to be kicking it from the 40, so it's about a 40, 41
yard. Wow, yeah.
And the kick is up. It has the distance, and it's through. So Guelph clawing back a little bit. York has to be happy that their defense held Jazz Lindsay in the offense to just 3 points.
That was definitely a huge stop for the York defense. They just let them get 3 points here, but at least it wasn't a touchdown, and they're not tied, and now they have a chance to get back on the field and put some more points on the board and expand their lead.
I'm just waiting for the first person to come out and kick a 50, 55-yard field goal. I don't know if you saw it this past week, but a high school kid actually kicked a 67-yarder. And here, as I say that, is Kyle Exume running up to the 40-yard line and picking up a nice chunk of yardage there.
67 yards. That's unbelievable.
And it had distance for more, too.
Wow.
It was a big kick.
Well, I guess needless to say, there are probably some NFL teams.
Probably have them on his radar already. Sebastian Janikowski, look out. So second and 5 on York's own 40-yard line. Miles Gibbon in shotgun. He's got Exume in the backfield, and he is looking to the left sideline. Has a receiver. Looks like Janelle Tolbert, rather. And that's a first down easily for York. So moving the chains again, and it looks like Miles Gibbon has had a pretty easy time picking up first downs so far.
Well, he's got the talent on the field to help him do that, Edon.
And it's something we haven't seen a lot of. He's been going down the field a lot this season, and the short passes, slants, and outs have really been working for the York offense because they have receivers who can get yards after the catch. And again, here's Gibbon in shotgun, and he gives it to his running back, playing his final game up across the 50 towards the 51-yard line, about 3-4 yards short of a first down, so second down coming up.
Kyle not only playing in his last game this season, but he just spent one season with the Lions. He's made a very lasting impact on this program, though.
Second down, 7:45 left in the first quarter. York up 7-4 early against the Guelph Gryphons after that 9-yard touchdown by Kyle Exume. So here's Gibbon on second down. Gives it to his running back and plowing forward really, really close to a first down.
It looks like it will be a first down.
Yeah, it looks.
By a yard.
After the pileup came up a little bit, the ball was clearly passed.
Yep, that's a first down.
Yeah, by a good yard almost.
Yep, it looks like it.
So York now, once again, two drives, and both times fairly easily getting across midfield.
They're in the black here on their right side of the 50-yard line anyway.
So now Gibbon again in shotgun, a formation he's been in for probably the majority of the season, and it's been very effective for him. And York calls a timeout, their first of the game. So early on, the York offense moving down the field, seemingly at will, now under 7 minutes left to go in the first quarter.
They seem really confident so far, Edon. It's very refreshing to see.
Well, it's great. This is the last time that they're going to be playing in front of this home crowd or playing a game this season. The playoffs out of reach officially now. So they want to give these fans a good last show. And for all the games we've seen so far this season here, the fan support has been fantastic.
Tons of family members of the York Lions in attendance tonight for the graduating players. There are quite a few of them, and as you say, they're probably going to want to have an amazing swan song here tonight, being that they're playing at home.
And once again, the away team showing a lot of support in the stands, too. A lot of fans made the way out from Guelph to be here, a lot of Guelph Gryphons fans in the house as well, so not just a York crowd. Now Miles Gibbon on first down from the 53-yard line, gives it to his running back. Or no, he keeps it himself, rather. A little confusion there on my part. And he crosses the 50-yard line. We'll bring up second down and about six? 5 yards, the official call. So halfway to a first down for York. And Gibbon again looks to be lining up in his favorite shotgun position. Has three wide on the right side. And he's looking down the field, keeps the ball himself, little pump fake, and goes down a couple of inches short, it looks.
Well, if it's third down in inches, do they go for it, Edon?
Well, they have a three-point lead, and if it's going to be inches, it looks very close. It's about three-quarters of a yard short, and they will go for it on third and less than one. And they have a toss play.
He got out of that one.
And
it looks like he made it.
Magic happened.
He knows
Kyle
he made it.
Exume looked to be down a bunch of yards short behind, but breaks a tackle. And first down York on the pitch play. It looked early to be a little iffy of a play call, but there's obviously a reason they called it, and it worked out well there for Coach Craney.
Well, Exume was just about taken down for a loss there. He had his ankles tied up a little bit, but he managed to get out of that tackle.
Clock ticking now, 5:30 left in the first quarter. York up 7-4. It's first and 10 from the Guelph 42-yard line. And Gibbon, once again, to his running back, his favorite weapon so far, and spinning
wow.
And churning his way forward.
Not only that, I think that he ran over the pile there, Edan.
It looks like his feet didn't even touch the ground.
No, it didn't.
He broke the line of scrimmage. So it's going to bring up second down and probably less than 5 yards, about 4 yards, maybe even 2 yards. 3 yards, pardon me.
The way that Exume is running today, we may see him look a little bit like we did the very first game of the season when his uniform was ripped to shreds by the end of the game because he kept bringing the Queen's Gales along with him.
Yep, and here is, well, nowhere to go there for Exume. Looked like the entire, everyone on the field was in that pile.
The Ottawa GGs, rather, not the Queen's Gales.
Third and two now. So another third down situation for the York offense, and do they elect to stay on the field and go for it? It looks like they do. So three third downs for York so far. They've gone for it on each one and have converted on the two that they've actually tried here. Will they convert their third one?
It's all based over the spot.
Well, Gibbon, the ball carrier there, is underneath a pile.
Oh, it's going to be close, really close. It'll all depend on the ball placement here.
Let's see what the refs do and who they rule this one in favor of. And this would be huge for York. And they give York the spot. So another first down, and now York 3-for-3 on third down conversions. And that is a number that any team would be proud of, I think, early on. Perfect 3-for-3 on third down conversions. Now just over 4 minutes left in the first quarter, and York marching down the field once again. It is 7-4 for the home squad here in their season finale.
Walker's in right now. Walker's in.
Miles Gibbon shotgun calls for it, and he gives it to his... Oh, a play-action fake to the corner,
oh!
And it is underthrown. Picked off just inside the 10-yard line, and run back. There's a flag down.
There's flags everywhere, Edan.
Flags everywhere, and Guelph is running this one back. Running way down, finally brought down inside the York red zone.
Well, let's see if this one is coming back, because there are two flags on the field, and it looks like it is.
York's got to be thankful that this one's at least coming back, because that was a huge run back after what looked like an unstoppable first two drives for York. They get picked off. Well, the ball was in the red zone. They were just outside the Guelph red zone, but a disastrous play there, underthrown by Miles Gibbon, and at least this one's coming back. So Guelph, not quite the field position that they'd hoped for, but at least they've got the ball.
Yeah, it's an unfortunate underthrow there by Miles Gibbon. Just couldn't reach a receiver. We have a throwing contest going on in the field right now. She's throwing for a gift certificate to Chili's Grill and Bar.
It looks to be just about a 5 yard pass there. So let's see if this lady here has quarterback in her future. Maybe short range third down, Tim Tebow.
She got it.
She nailed it. Looks displeased with herself. But a completion, not the greatest completion percentage. 1-for-2, 50% on the day.
Oh, you done.
So from sideline football, we get back to our OUA coverage here of Guelph at York. The season finale once again, just under 4 minutes left in the first quarter. York clinging to a 7-4 lead. And on that last drive, we saw York marching once again, but Miles Gibbon under throwing his receiver and picked off by the Guelph Gryphons. Now Jazz Lindsay back on the field.
Look for the DBs for York to come up huge here. They're going to want to get that ball back for Miles Gibbon.
Josh Small lining up closest to our broadcast booth, and he looks ready to go, his feet planted into the turf.
Both really small DBs for York. They're only 5'9", but they are extremely powerful.
And Jazz Lindsay calls for it and goes to the right side. Flag up right by the spot of the play. And it was thrown before the pass, so likely an offside coming.
Jordan Nugent is described by his teammates as shifty. So he's very difficult to take down once he's...
about that. He's very shifty.
Exactly.
So 3:25 left. Another offside call against York. So it'll bring up 1st and 5 on the 28-yard line. Lindsay again in shotgun. This one handed to his running back. Number
five. Looks like they got a first down there, and they're moving the chains. The York defense is going to have to come up huge here if they want to stop the Guelph Gryphons from marching down the field.
Now under 3 minutes to go, first quarter, 7-4 at York Stadium. The home Lions lead, and here's Lindsay giving it right back to his running back. That's Farkerson running up the sideline, picking up a good chunk of yards, and across the first down marker. So near the 50, well, near the 45-yard line. Refs haven't given the call yet for the first down, but they'll be moving the chains now. First down Guelph with 2:44 to go in the first. Down 3. Lindsay airs it down the middle. Oh, a great catch
there. Wow.
By Fraser again, the second catch of his by the day, and he just went up, climbed the ladder, and brought that one down. Looked to be well covered, but just got up and wanted that ball more. A big pickup for Guelph there.
Fraser's only 6 feet tall, but he looked about 6'6 on that catch. Huge vertical for to bring that ball down.
And now in York territory, across the 45-yard line on the, well, just inside the 44-yard line, and it's Farkerson again going up the middle, bowling his way up, and it's close to a first down once again. So a lot of close ball placements here, giving the chain gang a lot of work to do. And a first down conversion again for Guelph.
Guelph actually using their rookies, which is what Fraser is. He's only in his first year of eligibility here, Guelph.
Well, the trust that Lindsay has in him and that this offense has in him has to be good signs for the future. You don't see too often that freshmen make huge impacts, and he is early on in this game bringing it so far to York City. And here's Lindsay again, looks to the right side, and it's batted
tipped
down. It's number 10, the DB Andrew Collymore for York, flying in, crashing the line of scrimmage and getting a hand on that ball to bat it down. So second down and 10 for the Gryphons. 1:24 left to go in the first quarter. York still clinging to that 7-4 lead here in their season finale in front of the home crowd. And that's a bit of a cold one today at York. The coldest game we've seen so far this season.
Andrew Collymore's got one interception on the year so far.
And Lindsay airs this one down the field to a wide open Fraser, who just tumbles into the end zone. And as we're talking about the confidence and trust that Lindsay has, he airs it out to his freshman receiver. And Guelph takes the lead, 10-7, extra point coming.
Well, it's a little bit disappointing for the York Lions, but I'm sure that they'll pull it all together and get back into this game afterwards.
Yeah, there's a lot of time still left here. There's a minute left in the first quarter.
That was a 35-yard touchdown by the rookie, Andre Fraser.
So we'll likely be looking at a 4-point lead with just over a minute to go in the first quarter.
We'll probably be seeing Andre Fraser just improve more and more over the years since he's only in his first year of eligibility. He looks to be extremely athletic, so the sky's the limit for that receiver.
So the interception, the turnover for York, Miles Gibbons' 14th interception of the season, leads to a turnover that Guelph converts into a touchdown. So I don't think that's something that York's going to be wanting to do too often in this game. Miles Gibbon might want to make some adjustments, and it's a bit windy out there today, so he's going to have to factor that in when making his throws down the field. A lot of short passes so far for Gibbon in the offense, and then you see as soon as he goes deep down the field, the wind just catches that ball and underthrown a little bit perhaps as well, but now an opportunity to come back in this one, just down four.
Well, let's see if they can do it on the kickoff.
Wouldn't that be something?
Wouldn't
it? Kick return for touchdown. Get the momentum right back.
We get the credit for that now, you know. Come on, Exumé.
So Exumé now running this back. He's at the 20-yard line, chased towards the sidelines across the 25 and hit out somewhere around the 27-yard line.
Yeah, looks like he's about at the 27 there. Well, he wanted to return it for us, but the Guelph Gryphons had another idea.
Yeah, well, still a good return there for Exumé and giving the York some decent field position. They'll start at the 27-yard line. And up until that last interception, they've really shown the ability to move the ball downfield almost at will. We'll see what they do to adjust here. And
This is an illegal formation. They don't have a guy on the line there. To the bench.
Given directly under center. Gives it to Exumé, who is wrapped up immediately by three gold shirts.
Looks to be about second and eight. Same personnel here, so 66 coming off.
Well, they got 8 yards to go for a first down here, Edon.
So like you said, second and eight, now 15 seconds, clock running left in the first quarter, 11-7, the visiting Guelph Gryphons. We'll see if York gets off one more play here before the quarter ends. Now down inside 3 seconds to go. Gibbon takes the snap in shotgun and looks down the field and has a receiver who is hit midair and brought down hard. That's William Austin, number 84, and he looks to be just about a yard short. That we'll see where the refs call it.
That's Austin's first reception of the game. Pretty rare to see him not get a reception until right now, but there's been so much groundwork by the York Lions that he hasn't really had the opportunity.
And still no call, but they're going to...
It's quarter time here.
Looks like give York the first down. So it looked to be a bit short, but... Oh, no, they might not be. And that was the end of the first quarter there. So the guest, Guelph Gryphons, holding a 4-point lead, 11-7, here in the season finale at York Stadium.
And the teams will switch sides.
So start of the second quarter, York punts this one and a high punt doesn't even get to midfield.
So there's a flag on the play as well.
Likely be no yards there.
Yeah, that'll be a no yardage.
But an awful, awful punt followed by the penalty will give the Guelph Gryphons some pretty... Oh, penalty against, I don't even know who they're calling against, but it's going to be Guelph ball. No yards penalty there against York. And they will start at the 44-yard line. First and 10, 14:37 in the second quarter here at York Stadium. Jazz Lindsay with the snap, and there is play is blown dead immediately. Flags in the air on both sides of the line. So our PA guy officially calling flags everywhere.
He's doing a great job.
The official call on the field, flags everywhere. So a little comic relief up here in the broadcast booth. What better on a gloomy day? But gloomy, it's also good for football.
It is, actually. We're lucky that the rain has staved off, because I really thought that it was going to hammer down on us based on the fact that the sky is, in some parts, a very dark gray color.
Yeah, and I also don't think our camera is protected outside, so it would be great if the rain would hold off. From the 40 or the 39-yard line, Lindsay airs it deep down the field, has a receiver, but...
just barely missed that.
York got away with a huge, huge penalty there. That should have been a penalty on Nana Nkansa, who was holding on to the receiver there at the goal line. That's Carl Trivieri was wrapped up completely at the goal line and was throwing his arms up looking for a flag, but nothing doing there, so York gets away with a big one there. Second and 5 now for Lindsay and the Gryphons. Now the handoff to Farkerson. Stiff arm goes up towards the left side. And they'll get the first down.
Great job by Farkerson there to just put up the old stiff arm and gain the extra couple yards to get the first down for Guelph.
Well, he's had a great season. Oh, 811 yards coming into this one with 6 touchdowns and looking for more here in the season finale. Of course, Guelph will be heading on to the playoffs with a rather stellar 6-1 record. It's good for second in the OUA. Behind the number 1 McMaster Marauders, here is Lindsay looking. Pump fake to the left side, and now another pump fake to the left. Keeps it himself and picks up maybe a couple there.
Lots of pressure there from the York defense. He just had to get rid of it, or run it out of bounds himself, rather. Kellen Aiken by York chasing him down. He heard footsteps and had to get out of bounds there.
Well, I would too if I heard Kellen Aiken's footsteps coming up.
He's a pretty big guy.
On York's D there.
He's 6'1", but he's 245. That is
terrifying.
Like being hit with a freight train.
Yeah, absolutely. Now 2nd and 9, so a pickup of 1 there by Lindsay. Again in shotgun. I don't think I've seen him line up under center, but this time a short play on the little in. We'll bring up 3rd down.
Lindsay took a hit in the backfield there as well, just after releasing the ball. He looks to be okay, though.
We've seen York's defense get hammered with a couple of late hit on the quarterback calls this season, but a clean one there. So 3rd down and 9. And Guelph will be punting, electing not to kick the field goal. They had a 40-yarder before. This one just out of field goal range for the Gryphons, so punting the ball away.
It's a pretty decent punt. And that's out of bounds.
So Guelph picks up a point there. 12-7 now. York still only down by 1 score, down 5 points here with a good amount of football left to play. 12:33 left in the first half. Here at York Stadium, the finale for this new York Lions team with a lot of hope to look forward to for the next couple of seasons. Bringing in Miles Gibbon this year has really triggered a special season for York. The record again won't indicate it, but the first time they've won more than one game since 2005. And here's Gibbon and the offense again. Looks down towards the right side, and that is batted down at the last second. Well timed by number 14, Mackenzie Myers.
Yeah, that was aimed at William Austin there, but he couldn't haul it down. As you were saying, a very special season for York. But, I mean, this is just the beginning for them, I think. We spoke to Miles Gibbon. He's really excited about the talent that is on this team. And they're just kind of getting started. There are quite a few key players that are graduating. But Coach Craney has taken that into account when he handpicked the team that he has now.
Absolutely, and Gibbon now on second down. And he has a receiver open there, down the field.
That's Jesse Merton, number 89, with the reception.
So wide open there is Jesse Merton, and picks up a first down. And a big target that Miles Gibbons is going to be losing is number one, Janelle Tolbert, fifth-year receiver. And he's been so big for York in the past couple of seasons, but really developed a quick bond with Gibbon this season. Going to be troubling to lose him. I know they've been on Twitter talking to each other after losses. They're keeping each other on 2 feet, standing up, and it's going to be big for a lot of the rookies next year. And here's Gibbon keeping it himself, picking up a couple of yards. It's going to be some big shoes for the rookies and younger players next year for them to fill.
Well, absolutely. I mean, with Jesse Merton just taking that one, that's his first reception of the game, but Gibbon has only gone to Exume, Austin, Tolbert, and Griffith otherwise, and all of them are graduating this year.
Like you said, Kyle Exume playing in his last game, has a couple of OUA Player of the Weeks under his belt this season and has been so good in just his lone year at York, graduating after this season. And now Gibbon airs it out. It's short again, and that's to who we were just talking about, Janelle Tolbert. But it's no good, so third down coming up and seven. The punt team will come out for York.
Yeah, that was a pretty quick three and out.
Really the first time we've seen that quick three and out so far for York. Good job by Guelph's defense there. Nothing doing for Gibbon.
That's the first time we've seen a three and out really that quick in this entire game so far. So,
have we seen one yet, even?
No.
I don't think we've even seen one. So the first real big stop by a D there goes in favor of Guelph, and now York will punt it away, hoping for a little better punt this time than their previous, and they do get it. A nice punt backing Guelph up to the 20-yard line, and a nice little return there, a little jump and a step for the first 10 yards up around the 30-yard line is where Guelph will start.
That was a great punt by Henry Dervishi. We've seen Henry Dervishi struggle a little bit throughout this season as far as kicking field goals is concerned and punting, but I mean, most of that was caused by wind. We've seen some extremely, extremely windy games here at York Stadium this season, and I know that that has been a factor in many of the outcomes of the games.
Well, it's a very open field, and there's a lot of construction going around too, a lot of things going on, a lot of open air, and it's cold. It's getting to that time of the year, and here's the first play of the Gryphons' drive, barreling up to close to the first down marker, but just short, about 2 yards short. what's 10 minutes left to go in the first half of play. The visiting Guelph Gryphons holding a 5-point lead, 12-7 over the York Lions here in the season finale for both teams. Playoffs coming up for Guelph Gryphons, but not this year for York. Looking to the future is this rebuilding team, and Jazz Lindsay keeps this one himself, running to the right side and just tucks it away and runs, has the first down and a couple more. Is across the 45-yard line at about the 47. So a first down pickup for Lindsay, who has, coming into this one, had 233 yards with his legs.
We haven't seen Lindsay run nearly as much as Miles Gibbon today, but as you can see, he's got the ability to do so. He's pretty fast.
Lindsay in shotgun, and he's liked that so far to the sidelines. That's number 7, Saxon Lindsay, with the reception. Picks up about 2 or 3 yards there. And Jazz Lindsay likes to run just about on the season half as much as Miles Gibbon does, but is pretty effective on the ground. Runs 37 times versus Miles Gibbon 77, but 233 yards and 2 scores versus Gibbon's 388 and 2 touchdowns as well. So similar production from the quarterbacks on the ground. Lindsay just does it less, really.
Well, that was a Lindsay to Lindsay play, and they're actually brothers.
Well, look at that. So a little brotherly love on the field there for about 2 yards.
They're from Markham, Ontario. But Jazz is only in his second year of eligibility, whereas his older brother Saxon is in his fourth.
So a lot still to come from the young Jazz Lindsay.
Well, they'll have one more year of eligibility to play together.
Here's Lindsay looking down the middle of the field, and it is really short.
That was a great opportunity there for York to come up with that ball. There were four defenders and one receiver, but they just couldn't turn around and get their eyes on it.
And just a little disconnect there because number 21, the target, James Ingram, had a burst of speed after as he broke away from the defenders, but Jazz Lindsay underthrew that, so maybe a little miscommunication in the play call there. So third and eight coming up, and another three and out. So back-to-back three and outs.
Well, we've jinxed it now. We don't even have to turn our heads. It's all at center field.
Everything happening inside, well, not even inside the 20s, inside the 40s.
Exactly.
And a fair catch. Oh, no fair catch called, but that's number 22. Chris States on the return, and he's running from left side to right side, jumps a couple of defenders, and ultimately comes down just across the 20-yard line.
Chris States isn't that big of a guy. He's 5'10", but he's quick, as you can see.
A lot of quickness out there on this York Lions team. A lot of quickness, a lot of athleticism, a lot of players who can do a lot of things. And it starts with the running back, Kyle Exume, who's coming out on the field now. He can return the ball. He can run the ball. He's in the receiving game. And we've even seen him come out for some special teams and on defense late in games, making tackles. When the game no longer really means anything, he's still out there playing, so he's really the heart and soul of this York Lions team.
Well, exactly. His coaches even say that he embodies everything a football player should be and has been one of the best running backs in the OUA this season, while also taking snaps on defense and starting on special teams. He's been a fantastic leader and a mentor for the rest of the team, according to Coach Craney.
He's also become a favorite of offensive coordinator Michael Falls, a former quarterback himself, and actually the OUA leader in career passing yards when he played for the Western Mustangs just not too long ago, 4 years ago being his last season when they went to the Yates Cup and lost to the Queens Gales. But he's really brought the style that he played at Western over to this York offense. It is really a West Coast offense. They like to do a little bit of everything. They've sort of incorporated the running game into there, and Miles Gibbon embodies a lot of what Michael Falls used to be as well, running the ball and picking up yards with his legs, but also being able to gun it down the field.
Yeah, he really is a leader on the field and just showing his team that he cares. You know, it's not just about gaining a couple yards here and there and passing it off. He throws his body on the line for his team.
And he wants to win every time he's out there on the field, as any competitor should. Gives it to Exume, who runs to the outside, but nothing there.
You have to have a competitive streak in you in order to play NCAA football, which Miles Gibbon did, and he was the starting quarterback down there, so
starting quarterback for the South Alabama Jaguars.
Yeah, exactly, and he's brought that competitive spirit here to York, and it's rubbing off on the players, you can tell.
And this is actually the first season that the South Bama Jaguars are playing in a division, really. They were an independent team for the last few years, now playing in the Sun Belt. So their former starting quarterback runs and is flushed out of the pocket. He has nowhere to go but sidesteps all the defenders and gets a huge block there. Finally finds a guy wide open downfield. That's Alex Bugden. Number 16 is just left wide open. So Gibbon making some magic happen. Runs to the left side, sidesteps three defenders, gets a huge block.
He actually got a block from the Guelph Gryphons there. A huge one.
Just everything working in favor of York there, and a completely unbelievable play there, airing it down the field.
That play was a little bit of comic relief, if you ask me.
It worked in favor of York, and now they're close to midfield at just about the 52-yard line. A 31-yard pickup there for Miles Gibbon, going to Alex Bugden, and now Gibbon again. He decides to hand it to Exume, who runs across midfield. Picks up 4 yards, going to be about second and six, maybe second and seven. Now 6:45 left to go in the first half. York looking to claw back in this one, down just one score, 12-7 to the visiting Guelph Gryphons. So second and six from the 45.
That last play should give them a little bit of momentum here. We'll see what they can do. on second down.
And you can already see the Lions playing with a little bit of a swagger here in their season finale. They want to put on a good show and get the W. And a little fake there, and a huge stiff arm by Gibbons. So he goes across the first down marker into Guelph territory, and at just
Gibbons not moving.
Yard line, but he is down,
uh-oh,
moving, and is hurt.
Well, this won't be good news for the York Lions.
And he is banging his head down on the ground.
Although it...
York players all around him right now, and he still hasn't moved. But I saw his leg flailing a little bit and saw his head moving, so... This is just about the biggest injury that could happen to York.
It looked like he was slammed into the ground, maybe his shoulder there, Edon.
Well, he got up, and he's running off to the sideline.
Well, that's good. Seems to be all right. Maybe just had the... Well, I'm sure he wouldn't be up if he knocked the wind out of himself, but...
So now he's going to go to the sidelines for maybe a couple plays. In comes another player playing in his final game today. This is the backup quarterback, number 12, Dimtar Sevdin, who we saw a couple weeks ago in the last home game, the first ever night game at York. He came in late in that blowout game, and he looked pretty good. So gets handed the reins here in Guelph territory. We'll see what he can do. First and 10 on the 45. Takes it in shotgun and looks down the left side. William Austin picked it up, but it's an offside.
Sevdin does have one touchdown this season so far. He's passed for 70 yards, 48 being the largest gain. So he could throw a touchdown pass here. He's done it. He's been able to throw that far before. So.
And Sevdin actually went to high school, was starting quarterback for our former PA guy, Andrew Canejo's high school team. And when speaking to Andrew Canejo a couple weeks ago about him, he said that Sevdin was really the heart of that team as well, so not as much of an opportunity this year with Gibbon coming in, but still a good quarterback. They still trust him with their playbook, and now at first and 15, they trust him to get into the red zone and pick up a lead here for York. And he's going to trust it to Kyle Exume, who runs up to about the 50 or 45-yard line.
A great gain there by Kyle Exume.
So a little... Tebow that worked there for Sevdin comes in a relief for the starting quarterback, and right back out on the field comes Miles Gibbon, the starting quarterback. He looks to be just about in the shape he was before getting hurt, and back in shotgun formation with his running back tailing behind him.
Well, they're going to go
wide, and Gibbon running, looks down the left side, sidesteps again, and he does it one more time, this time a little shorter pass and no one there. But again, showing the ability to sidestep defenders and juke them out.
Well, we've got third down here now in 10. So.
Another three and out. We've seen three in a row now.
Too bad they didn't have that kid from that high school in the States. They could kick a 67-yard field goal right now.
I had to watch that video three or four times yesterday because it was completely ridiculous. None of the kids believed it either. They had two guys back to return the field goal, because they thought it was going to be short, and they just threw their hands up in the air after and were like, that's impossible.
I would like to have this kid tested.
And he probably had room for another 10 yards under it, too. So now a punt and another nice punt here for York. Haven't seen too much of that this season, but a great couple in a row here. And getting backed up. Getting backed up and getting a couple of blocks. Finally dragged out across the 30-yard line at the 32. And what looked like could have been a great stop by the York special teams turns out to be a pretty good return for Guelph.
Audrey Frazier again, the rookie. The legs on him. He is so quick. The Guelph Gryphons are definitely lucky to have him, and as a rookie, he's only going to develop into a better and better player. And the fact that they trust him with the ball so much is pretty surprising.
You know, Lindsay's only in his second year, so he has a lot of time to develop and grow with Frazier and to build that rapport over the next couple of years, and I feel like that's going to be something people are going to have to start watching out for in the next couple of years.
Well, Frazier could have a huge game already today. He had 84 yards in the first quarter and a touchdown.
It's just silly.
It is silly, Don. And, I mean, we're not even halfway through the game yet, so he's pushing for well over 100 yards. And
Guelph, after the penalty, starts at their own 1-yard line. and barely managing to get out of their own end zone as the clock ticks down. So it's going to be second down and one, so just managing to get out back to the one-yard line. York sniffing safety. Under 4 minutes, 3:50 to go. The guest Guelph Gryphons still holding a 5-point lead. It's 12-7 here at York Stadium. Week 8 action on SSN Canada. And Lindsay batted down.
Kyle Exumé coming up huge on defense,
were we
as
not
usual.
Talking about that, Exumé coming in on defense, the Swiss Army knife of this team, and batted down on third and one. So a great, great stand and a fourth straight three and out for these teams. But that was the biggest one yet. They're going to be punting from well inside their own end zone. And presumably York is going to have an opportunity with 3:41 here to take a lead going into half, or at least to take a lead with just a little bit left on the clock with some pretty good starting field position. Chris States lining up back out at the 35-yard line with Jordan Nugent, so not expecting a booming punt.
Yeah, they're really close here.
Down at the 35 and the 40. So if they return a punt at those either of those yard lines, they could potentially kick a field goal on first down and nail it. Not going to do that, of course, but...
States looks to be ready to go back if he has to.
And Guelph will just take a knee and concede the safety to give themselves a little bit better field position and prevent York from scoring a touchdown.
Which, by the looks of Kyle Exumé, he really wanted to do.
So now, what was a 5-point lead becomes a 3-point lead. York down 12-9 now, 3:17 left in the first half. And this game's gone pretty quickly so far. Not much scoring, but a lot of defense, and it's tightly contested. I don't know if anyone thought it would be quite this tight contested, but a lot of football left to play. York just down 3. Both defenses playing well. Both offenses... a little hit or miss so far, but both offenses showing the ability to move the ball down the field. And here's Gibbon under center. Gives it play action down the middle of the field. There's Janelle Tolbert, and just out of his reach. Looked like he slowed down a little bit at the end.
Good coverage there as well by the Guelph Gryphons.
Gibbon's shown desire to get the ball over to Tolbert a little bit more this game. Again, his last one with the York Lions. Right down the middle of the field there, had an opportunity for a big gain. But no go, so just over three minutes to go. 12-9, Guelph still. Second down and 10 from the 35-yard line. York's own 35-yard line. And coming in off the sidelines, Alex Bugden and Jesse Merton, numbers 16 and 89 respectively. Gibbon in shotgun, keeps it himself, runs up, but is wrapped up by two Guelph defenders. So third down. And about 6 or 7 yards.
It looked like
teams coming out.
Looked like he might have had a bit of a seam there, but Cameron Walker for Guelph was there to just shut him right down.
Yeah, closed up really quickly. And I think I know there was an opening there for a little bit, but it just closed right up. Good job by the Guelph defense. And they'll get the ball back with just over 2.5 minutes to go in the first half.
No, as you were mentioning that... it is surprising that this game is close just based on the records and the fact that Guelph is in the playoffs and York isn't. But the York Lions have been fighting that way for the entire season. And with the exception of their game versus McMaster, all of their games have been extremely, extremely close. You know, they haven't really lost most of their games by more than 4 points.
Yeah, I think they had three straight losses there in the combined, or four losses in a row, but three of the losses... before the blowout to McMaster, they lost by a combined 9 points. So they've been in games all year, and barring just a couple of miscues, and if they had a couple more minutes, you could be looking at a completely different record, possibly a 5-2 squad. And how a couple of minutes and a couple of plays just changed the outcome of an entire season, it's exactly what's happened to York. So outside of the loss to Queens and the loss to McMaster, who are the number one team in the nation and have yet to lose this season, there could have been 5 wins in the bag for York this season, and despite the losses, a lot of hope for years to come for this team, who have really, really developed and changed under Coach Craney in his short tenure so far.
Absolutely. The close games are definitely an indication of that.
Now the punt team out for York. Just over 2:30. Clock ticking and a high snap, but getting it off with a nice punt again. So a couple of nice punts in a row. A good job by York to prevent a big game, but it's going to be the 41-yard line, Guelph zone 41-yard line. Over 2 minutes to go still in this first half, down, or rather up, 12-9 are the Gryphons.
I'm going to give Henry Dervishi some credit for that as well, for not allowing that snap to go over his head. We have some fans playing with us, trying to block our view from the game.
Jazz Lindsay setting up, getting his offense on the field, takes the snap, and it's a little end around, but wrapped up for a loss.
Taken down by Hussein Hazime, and he, or Hazim rather, not Hazime. I keep thinking that it's Exime. They end, their names end the same way. But he is one of the captains of the team and a great leader, and as you can see, that is why.
Josh Small, number 4, the defensive back, also in there, came in a little after. But a nice tackle for loss there, the first one of the game for either side. Second and 12.
At a difference of 60 pounds between those two, I'm going to say that Hazim had a bigger impact.
I think so, yeah. And now Lindsay looking down the field, the left side, and it's picked off Josh Small, but...
But did he keep it in?
No, it doesn't look like it. He was in the air when he did it and landed...
Just outside.
Just outside, but Josh Small making an impact, and even though he's out of bounds, diving for it, laying out. So now third down and 12, and another three... Well, I would say so. Let's see what they elect to do here. A minute and 54 to go. Always the chance of some trickery.
Well, they are in a huddle right now, so you never know what they're going to do.
Well, punter Daniel Ferraro is out there changing the formation a little bit, and Ferraro is, yeah, they kick it away cleanly, and Chris States returns it cleanly. But is brought down, fumble. Chris States fumbles
and he picks
the ball,
it back up.
Picks it up, so good job by States there to prevent disaster because he was the only red shirt back there, and Guelph could have taken that all the way back to the house for a score.
You said it, Edon, that would have been disastrous, but a great job to pick up the bouncing ball. He was lucky that it didn't go in the wrong direction.
Well, that could have made this go from being a pretty tight game into the half to a little bit less tight.
Not too many turnovers so far.
No, just that one pick there by Miles Gibbon, which was underthrown. I don't know if you attribute that to the wind or not, but just really that, and then the fumble there recovered by States, and here's Gibbon giving it to Exume. It's wrapped up by a ton of Griffin's defenders. Just fights back to the line of scrimmage. Just over a minute 30 in the first half, minute 36 left on the clock, 12-9 Guelph over York at York Stadium in this season finale. For both teams, York looking to pick up their third win of the season, which would equal their highest total since 2005, when they actually got 3 wins, and that's the most wins they've had this season, rather, is the most wins they've had since then. So a lot going right for York so far.
Well, they're all really confident in their team as well. And as I said, Coach Craney has built these guys. It has been a building process. He came in after the 2005 season. So he didn't have much to work with. But he went out and he scouted and he found a lot of players. And to be honest, most of them are from the GTA region. He is convinced that the most talent for football is in this region. And that's why he concentrates here when it comes to scouting.
Well, it makes sense because this is a big city and the program development is at its biggest here. And a great strategy by Coach Craney to bring in local players. It helps fans come out to the games as well. They want to see their friends and family. And we've seen it in the stands this season, a lot of fans coming out for York. And here's Gibbon on second down and a little bit of a miscommunication there. Throws it more towards the right shoulder than Merton would have liked. Now third down. Another three and out, so the punt team will come out and give the ball back to Guelph with a minute 31 left to play in the first half.
not a lot of food trucks here today either.
It's disappointing.
I know. I was really excited for some smoked poutinerie.
I was too. I got a pulled pork sandwich at homecoming. It was amazing.
Oh, that sounds good.
It was about the size of my head and the most dangerous thing I've ever eaten while driving. So do not do that if you ever have a pulled pork sandwich.
Note to self, don't drive while eating pulled pork. So another booming punt for York here, returned just inside the 30-yard line.
This will be 37-yard line.
I think there's still pulled pork in my car somewhere.
Ooh.
It got everywhere.
Save that for me.
I'll be sure to do that.
2 weeks old, that's fine.
Probably longer than that. Homecoming was about a month ago.
So long.
And that's a first down. Ball on the 37.
So under a minute and a half left to go in the first half here. Guelph looking to increase their lead here on this drive. Minute 21 left to go and up 3 points against the home guys. First and 10 from the 37-yard line. Jazz Lindsay calls for a shotgun, and he slips a little bit and just throws it down to the ground.
Yeah, that was a grounded ball for sure. He just threw it straight down.
Slipped a little bit on his play action to Farkerson. Brings up a quick second down.
Looks like we might have an injury on the field to York here for number 37, James Tuck. He's down on one knee. Doesn't look too bad, but the trainers are tending to him now.
Well, and if it's anything but the ability for him to get out on the field after this play, it's a big loss for York. He leads the team with 6.5 sacks, and he's been a terror on the D-line this year for them.
And the Aurora, Ontario native made his way off the field, and he looks to be okay.
Second down and 10. 37-yard line still for Guelph. And down the field, but another overthrow. We've seen a couple of basically 5-yard overthrows by Lindsay, and that's another one there. His receiver had a beat and just couldn't hook up with him there.
Neither quarterbacks today seem to really have the accuracy that we're used to seeing from both of them. I'm not sure. It is a little bit windy, like you said, so that could have a factor. But I'm betting that it might be a little bit of the cold as well. It's hard to get a good grip on the ball when your hands are freezing.
Definitely. And it's pretty cold out there with, you know, the winter weather starting to come. Winter is coming, and
so is lunch.
So is lunch. Lunch is coming. Pizza coming up the stairs now. And that was exciting. And this will just be, play will be blown dead. Chris Dace was back there to return the punt, and it was a good punt, but we'll do it again.
Not bad.
Except this time we'll do it from 5 yards further back. So it appears that I was kidding. We won't do it from 5 yards back. The same thing, third and 10, but the punt is up and a pretty equal punt, maybe a bit shorter and higher. So York, with 1:05, will have an opportunity once again. And it was just about 1.5 minutes ago when I thought that York would have the ball to at midfield and be able to drive down and really close out the second half with a score. And we've seen 3 or 4 drives in between then, so a bunch of 3-and-outs and quick 3-and-outs.
A lot of high punts today by the punter for Guelph, Daniel Ferrero. The wind is blowing back that way as well, so that might have a factor.
And Dimitar Sevden in the game now at quarterback again. Don't know what happened to Gibbon, but that's a completion.
Okay. Looks like Alex Bugden took that one in. So not just a quarterback change here, but some receiver changes as well.
With under 1 minute now in the first half left to go, it's Sevden still there. in shotgun, and he's marching down the field. A quick pass there to Bugden picks up a good chunk and now looks down the field. And a completion, no, dropped at the last second. Can't quite tell who it is there.
Again.
But it's Bugden again. He's going right back to him. Can't haul it in.
That's too bad for Bugden, but you know, you can tell that he's really worked hard this season. Look at how much faster he's gotten getting out there, and he is a very, very smart receiver. His work ethic really stands out on the team as well.
So second and 10, 46 seconds in the first half. York just across midfield, and it's Sevden looking to the left sideline, has William Austin, and he breaks away from the tackle for a first down and more, and chased down just outside, or inside rather, the 10-yard line. So a great spin move by William Austin.
Taken down by Taylor Palmer there, just shy of a touchdown.
So the ball's on the 10-yard line. It's going to be first and goal.
This is a great opportunity for York to take the lead just before the half.
And even if
get them some great momentum.
They have an opportunity to tie it in great field goal range right now. It would be just over a 10-yard try. And here's Sevden looking to the back corner to Janelle Tolbert, but batted down. A lot of contact there when they both went up, but contact from both sides, and receivers let that slide.
The referees. The original gain on that first large play there was 37 yards.
Now just over a half minute, 31 seconds, 12-9 still for the Gryphons, but York in great scoring range right now on the 10-yard line. It's second and goal. And Sevden still in at quarterback. Calls for the snap and is looking right. And just out of Exume's hands, he is clearly unhappy. An opportunity there for a score, and just drops it. Claps right out of his hands. So third down, and the field goal unit comes out to try and tie this one up with just over 25 seconds.
Exume was wide open on that pass. It's really unfortunate for him that he dropped it. But the Gryphons are very happy about that, that they're not going to be going into the half down. They will be tied, equal momentum coming back out on the field. Although York might have slight advantage since they are the last team to score.
And that's Dervishi just under about a 17. And the field goal is blocked. The 17-yard attempt is blocked and run back across the 30, across the 40. So a massive swing of momentum. York can't get the ball in the end zone after the 37-yard hookup, looking for the 17-yard field goal, and looks like they're going to tie it up at 12-12, but it's blocked by Guelph and run back near midfield. And with 15, or it's going to be called back, but with 15 seconds to go, Guelph has the ball and still have a three-point lead. They have a couple of chances maybe to increase their lead, and they'll get the ball at the half.
Well, so much for that momentum for York going into the half. Michael Millar had other ideas blocking that field goal attempt.
Just a complete change of situation right here. York could have been tied right now going into the half. Still down three. Receiver slips, and there's a flag. Two flags during the play. Flags are everywhere. Again.
I thought I saw three there for a second, but it was Dylan Dimitrov's shoes.
Dylan Dimitrov, a name we haven't heard that much today, if at all. He's their leading receiver with 324 yards and two touchdowns. Doesn't lead them in touchdowns, though. That's Saxon Lindsay, brother of quarterback Jazz Lindsay. He has three. But the yards leader for them, Dimitrov, kept largely in check so far in the first half, which now has just 11 seconds left in it. So first and 15 from the 40-yard line. Lindsay keeps it himself and is rolling right, airs it out towards the sidelines, but that's well out of play. 5 seconds, so one more play will be coming for Guelph, and that's going to be on second and 15.
I have a feeling York is going to come out in the second half and really want to sort of redeem themselves for not being able to tie it.
Well, they're going to have to keep the defensive intensity that they've put together so far in the first half, because they're going to come out and can't be sluggish. If they come out on defense in the first drive and they give up a touchdown, this lead all of a sudden opens up for Guelph, and it's going to be hard to get the momentum back, especially in the weather conditions of today. So York is going to have to keep the fire alive throughout the halftime break. And here for the final play is Lindsay. He gives it to Farkerson, who runs it up the middle. And that brings the first half to a close. Guelph, the Gryphons, holding a three-point lead. It is 12-9 at halftime here at York Stadium. The home York Lions still in it, though. Second half coming up in just a few minutes.
Welcome, everyone, to the second half of our coverage here on SSN Canada of Week 8 OUA football. We have the York Lions taking on the Guelph Gryphons in both team season finale here at York Stadium. It's graduating player day. A lot of familiar faces on this York team will not be here next year, so they're looking to put on a show in front of the home crowd. Score, though, not so much in their favor as they look to kick off here to begin the second half. They're down 12-9, so still game definitely within reach, and the second half is officially underway. Third quarter of action, and a huge return gets the quarter kicked off, gets the half kicked off, and it's Fraser again running it up across the 50-yard line, but a flag is thrown on the return, so we'll see how far back they bring this one, or if they do bring it back. Either way, first down for Jazz Lindsay at the Guelph Gryphons offense.
That's a good way to get them started off in this half. Looks like they're taking the momentum into this one after blocking that field goal attempt by the York Lions late in the first half. But that's coming right back.
And it's coming way back.
Way back.
A huge return. It's going to be first and 10 on the 20-yard line for the Gryphons. So 12-9 looking to tack onto their lead, looking to increase it and continue their dominant regular season. And it's Lindsay right at the middle of the field. It's Fraser again, his favorite target today, wrapped up just before the first down marker.
Good job by Fraser there to hold on to that ball too. It looked like it almost slipped out of his hand right before he hit the ground, but he held right onto that. So that's another good gain for the rookie.
And after 40 seconds tick away in this first second half, it's just over a 9-yard gain, so half a yard to go for the first down marker. It's second down and less than one. Lindsay in shotgun. And he just gives the ball back to Farkerson, and he plugs his way right up the middle, met by a bunch of defenders who